So, we saw how to change characters. Let's actually see how we holster the weapons and how we can have the unarmed state. Let's open up the Weapon Manager. And basically what we need to take care is we're going to add a boolean to check if the weapon is actually a melee weapon or if it has a holster weapon. So since we add a few references over here, and since there is going to be weapons that do not have they do not have a weapon model, so they wouldn't have a model animator, they wouldn't have an IK holder, and not have a right hand target, right hand rotation, and everything else. Okay, because they are melee. And even though they are melee, though, if you want to have other weapons, like not be unarmed, okay, so you want to have like knives or everything else like that, and use it like you see in Fallout, instead of using how melee works in let's say GTA or Metal Gear, okay, and then you can also add an integer. I'm not going to add it here, so I'm just going to mention it. Okay, you can add an integer that basically checks what animations to play. So in case you want to have animations for melee and all that stuff, you can check you're probably going to have a different blend trees for its state, because if you have a melee, you probably cannot aim from cover. Okay, so this is all stuff you need to think when you create your game or when you design your game. Okay, but since you will have an integer that checks for your weapon, and we actually can add it, since you also want to have different animations for when you're holding the rifle or when you're holding the pistol, you can also do that from there. But I'm not going to add it, I'm just mentioning. So, since we have new variables and new types of weapons that can not have everything else, that means we need to take care to actually, when we are changing the weapons, to actually add a lot more if statements. So let's start over here. If when we want to change a weapon by index, okay, we have everything else as it was, and if we had a previous weapon, then we need to now check if that previous weapon actually had a weapon model. So to check that, we check if the weapon model, if the current weapon model wasn't null. If it wasn't, then we know we can disable it. And so if it had a weapon model, it probably had an IK holder too. If our current weapon also had a holster weapon, then that means we want to enable the holster weapon, since we are no longer holding our weapon. Okay, let's remove this one. So moving on, we need to add new checks for the holster weapon. So if the new weapon has a holster weapon, we will also disable the holster weapon. We also need to change, previously we directly applied the right hand IK target to the right hand target and so on, because there wasn't any weapons that wouldn't have a right hand IK target, because there wouldn't be a reason to create an IK targeting system. Okay. So, now that this is not the case anymore, we need to add all the new if statement. So if the new weapon has a right hand IK target, only then assign it to the IK handler, else set it to null. We need to set this to null because it might keep the references to the previous weapon and it's not something we want. Same for right hand rotation, same for the left hand target. Okay, continuing on. So, ignore my high-tech ringtone and moving on. Yeah, I would have probably edited this out, but if I wasn't too lazy, I would have probably done a lot more stuff in my life. So, moving on. We also need to change a bit the stuff we have over here. Okay. Previously, we assigned the weapon model. We need to check if we have actually a weapon model, then enable it, and if we actually have an IK holder to actually enable it. And now, this way is pretty much simple to do and simple to add it. Basically, if you forget to add an if statement somewhere, you're going to get an error. Then you can come over here and just add, and you can just add if there's actually, if it's not null, then assign it. Okay, it's pretty simple to do. Similarly, since we have two weapons and we were lazy to encapsulate the whole switching to one function, we can do it over here. We need to add them over here too. Okay, let's not be lazy. Let's try and add it right now. Okay, so I'm going to take all this and I'm going to delete this. We have a function that returns current weapon with desired index. So let's see if we have a function that returns with, no, we don't. Well, let's create it anyway. We have our desired index. So let's create a target weapon. And we will say return current weapon with ID. And for ID, we're going to pass, we have the index, so we can go and say available weapons and desired index. Okay. And does this have some errors? Desired index, and it needs to pass an ID, so we will pass the weapon ID. And simple like that, we have our target weapon, so we can call this function now. And I should have probably think that before I added this, but anyway, we can call the switch weapon with target weapon, so we call this function, and we only need to come over here and say that the weapon index is the desired index. And that's just a simple encapsulation. So the changes we did on the other function, we need to actually do them here too. And that is check if there is a weapon model, check if there is a holster weapon and enable it. And moving on, the changes we did over here. Basically, wherever you assign something, you first need to check if there is actually a reference to that. Okay, otherwise you're going to be having problems. For instance, bullet spawn point. This will also have a reference over here. Okay, and so on and so on. Since these are floats, there's no point doing anything else over here. We're going to remove that. And We probably should set this up for the muzzle. For the muzzle too. But yeah, now that I think of it, it's not really that necessary since when we have an unarmed weapon, we just disable everything. So I do think that we just disable the shooting, we disable the aiming, so there's no point really. Okay, so let's just keep it as this and let's play dangerously. The changes we did over here, and when we close the weapons, when we close all weapons, we can come and say we also want to close the holster weapons. So if the current weapon we are looking at has the holster weapon disabled, then you can not if it has a holster weapon, then you want to disable it because this closes the weapons, not the available weapons. We saw our populate and return shareable list, so let's close that and we can continue on now. Let's see what other changes we need to do. Now I think on our weapon manager we only have yes, this one. So inside the update into the weapon manager we want to test the how we are unarmed or not. Okay, so we go and say into if we press the H key, if you remember, of course you need to add this somewhere else and not inside the weapon manager. For instance, you need to add this into the input handler because if you have enemies that have this weapon manager and you hit the key, the enemies will also switch weapons. And of course, it's not something you want. So, if you press the H key, you say to if the state manager is not on melee weapon, you call the function to switch the weapon with the target weapon, and the target weapon will be the unarmed weapon. Which the unarmed weapon is over here, it's a public weapon reference base, it's unarmed. Since this is a class, a serialized class, and it's also public, then this cannot be, in most cases, cannot be null. Okay, so don't do if not unarmed, basically. Don't do this. Or, to be more specific, not equals null. Okay, this will always be false. In most cases. There are some cases that this might not actually work. So, if it was, if the state manager wasn't already on melee, then switch target to the unarmed weapon and make them to be melee. If it was on melee, then switch to the target weapon to the weapon index we had, and state melee weapon will be false. Now we need to do a few changes on the IK handler and the rest, handle animation, the input handler, and all that. Let's see them. IK handler. Yeah. Not this one. I don't think we did anything over here. And the changes we need to do is on. Probably, yeah, over here on fixed update. If the state managers, if the state manager is not a melee weapon, do everything as we were doing it before with no change. But if it is, then we cannot use the IK, there's no IK targets, there's nothing over there. So we only need to make the look weight to zero. Okay. Simple enough. We simply disable the logic we wrote in the previous videos. And I have no idea why this exists. So let's just keep it over here. on handle shooting. We need to check if the state manager are not on a melee weapon. Then I basically had everything in here encapsulated into a function. Everything we have over here was inside the update. Just cut and paste them inside their own function and just add this if statement. So if the state manager says that we do not have a melee weapon, then just move, just you can play the shooting, you can start the shooting logic and all that. On handle animation, it's basically the place where you will actually want to expand a lot more. As I said, the animations are always a problem. Okay, you can come over here and say if the animator bool unarmed is true or false, is controlled by if the state manager says we have a melee weapon or not. And in turn, it's going to come over here. Since I only have one idle animation, I have it on the upper body layer where we have our reload enable and all that, and create a new parameter that says unarmed. If unarmed is true and he's not running, because otherwise the if I was running and having it would be playing the running animation on the lower body, and on the upper body will just keep on the idle animation. Okay, so unarm, if unarm is true and the forward is less than 0.1, then it will transition to this state. If it's not unarmed or it's not forward. Now, these are two different transitions. They are not different conditions. Okay. Then it will go back into playing a state that does not have an animation. So that means it's going to be playing the below layer, the base layer. As I said, you probably need to have, if you're going to have a lot of melee focused gameplay, as I said, you probably need to have this into a whole different animation state or animation layer that has all the animations that do not have that you do not need into the animations, into the unarmed state. Okay, but as I said, animations are always a pain in the butt to work. And basically, I think it's mostly why a lot of people do not make 3D games, because animations are tough to find. So, moving on. The only thing we need to set from the inspector is on our weapon manager, we have our available weapons, and on unarmed weapon, we can come over here and say melee weapon, it's true. Of course, we can also do that from the script, but let's not. So, I think we've covered everything that we needed to cover. So let's see it once again, one last time. I'm gonna hit H and it's going to play the idle animation. This idle animation is from the raw mockup data. It's from Unity's own free animations they give, so I'm not even going to bother adding it. Okay, and you can see that when he actually moves, it's playing the animation with no weapon hub. If I have other running animation that wasn't that horrible, then I will just make him, instead of playing this animation, I will just have him play that animation. And if I hit H once again, it's going to have his gun back, and Johnny got his gun, so he's playing He does everything else we've created in the previous 11 parts, and even more if you count the extras too. Okay, so I'll end this part here. Don't forget to like and subscribe. If you'd like to see more, then consider supporting and or picking a project or two from Gumroad. Okay, so we can continue, keep creating and making all this cool stuff. And also, if you also have suggestions for series or what else we can add into this project or any other project, of course, feel free to leave it inside, to leave it in the comments, okay, or contact me with suggestions, because why not? So, I'll see you next time.